Good afternoon, students. This is a new teacher by name Sanjay Nadvada Kulkarni. Okay, and I will be teaching you English. Okay, and today as how we have a new poem that we are going to learn togetherly. That is how to tell wild animals by Caroline Wells. And we are going to know about this poem today. Okay. Before that, let's have a thought of the poem before it. What is the quotation or thought for today? Education is the manifestation of mind, body and soul. So we have to manifest ourselves, learn about education. We should know about the both does and don'ts, aware and unaware. Both the things are very important to be in our life. Okay, about the good and the bad, about the small and the big. So today we are going to know about how to tell wild animals by Caroline Wells. Is it not a strange when we listen the name of the poem is how to tell wild animals? We never came in a contact with animals in today's life. Okay, to some extent we might have come in a contact, like example, a domesticated animals. Is it not? Like dog, cat, etc. Okay, but here now how we are going to tell the wild animals is the biggest question, because we never had in touch with the animals and all. Now why we are telling this poem is that because we are civilized and now we are making deforestation and the animals are found coming into our homes, in our towns and cities. Is it not? So let's see what Caroline Wells want to say about the poem How to Tell Wild Animals. It is written by Caroline Wells. Caroline Wells was an American poet. So we let us know about the poet also. She was born in Rahway, New Jersey in the United States of America on 18 June. The name of the place is Rahway and born in United States of America. Okay, in year 18 June 1862 to Anna Wells and William Wells. Now two means whom? Anna Wells and William Wells, they are the parents. Anna Wells is the mother, William Wells is the father. She was married to Edwin Houghton. After finishing her school, she worked as a librarian for the Rahway Library Association. Later on, she started to go for librarian work after her schooling and worked for the Rahway Librarian Association in the same place, based on the name of the place only, Rahway Librarian Association, Library Association. Her first book was published in 1896. So she was also a well-known writer. She had a very good hobby to write about the things, whatever she admired and experienced. And so the first book came into existence and published, that was in 1896. Central idea of the poem. Now let us know the central idea. Central idea means what? The summary of the poem. Okay, the poet Caroline Wells treats even ferocious animals and beasts with a coat of gentle but weird humor. So Caroline Wells is telling us about what? About the beasts, the ferocious animals, very wild animals, okay, who are fond of eating flesh, okay. She also tells about the humor of the poem. Now, what should be the humor of the poem about the kindness? Is it not? But where is the kindness in the poem that we are going to see? If you see a huge terrible beast coming to you in the eastern forest, and if you are dying, when he roars, then no, it was an ancient lion. So when you are walking in the eastern forest and you see a Asian lion is coming in front of you in the eastern parts of the forest and it starts roaring, then you can understand your death has come near by the roaring of the animal. The humor is created by various beasts of prey and he roars of prey differently. So this is the example. You can see a different kind of a humor and attitude is found in the animals. Okay, someone roars, someone jump someone, pull someone, kill someone, bites, depends. Because all animals are having individual difference and their humor is shown in a different tendency or in different ways. The Bengal tiger is noble but eats you the moment he notices you. The Bengal tiger is a very noble. Noble means rich and powerful. But as how he sees you, it attacks you and kills you and starts eating. The leopard with peppered spots with only left and left again. Now how is this? The leopard with the left and left again, a dotted spots on the body. Okay. Like a pepper. Pepper means P-E-P-P-E-R. Pepper is a species or a spices we call masala. The seemingly friendly hug leads to fatal results and then comes the seemingly resulting into a hug. Now, what is this resulting friendly hug? The friendly hug is welcoming you, and this is done by whom? By the bear, B-E-A-R. And the result is cattle. Once if it hugs you enough, it squeezes you like a cloth, okay, and we are in. The crocodile weeping and hyenas merry, but weird smile deceive their victims. Now the crocodiles weeping here. The crocodiles are weeping, but don't go on their weeping. They are doing show off. Okay. And hyenas merry. And hyenas are very happy, showing that their smile on their face. Okay. But they always walk in a group to kill an animal. But weird smile deceives their victims. But weird smile deceives their victims. But don't go on their smile. They will deceive you. Okay. They will cheat you and they will kill you. Let us know about the style of the poem. The style of the poem is humorous. How is the poem style? It is very humorous. Okay. The humorous poem suggests some dangerous ways to identify wild animals. This humorous way tells us about the wild activity of that particular animal. The use of words and emotions are not only humorous but ironical as well. In the poem you can see emotional, okay, then after the words like humorous are also there, simultaneously ironical also. Ironical, it tells about to dare to excel with the hard enough, okay, hard enough to dare and excel, to lead forward, okay, with no any kind of a sympathy, okay. It is ironical that the noble Bengal tiger eats you the moment he sees you. Now, where is the important ironical thing is? In the noble Bengal tiger. Noble by rich. He is rich, but he will not give any excuse to any other creature. He will kill. Remember. And will eat. No excuse in front of noble Bengal tiger. The friendly hug of the bear is deadly. Once if it welcomes you and friendly hugs you enough, in the one hug only is enough. If still you find somewhere alive and somewhere movement is there, another press, that is another caress is being taken by the animal. Okay, care is taken means to kill. Okay, one more press is enough. The rhyme of the scheme of the stanza is AB, AB and CC. You should know the words matching with the similar sound. AB, AB and CC. That is in the poem. That when we read the poem, we come to know the rhyming scheme. The poet takes liberties with the language to create the desired poetic effects. Now, why the poet is taking the freedom, the liberty to make the poetic devices to understand for us and to make the poem effective? So that we should know the animal's life, the lifestyle, and with the help of that, we can come to know about the language usage and the words used in the poem. For example, the words leapt and leapt, L-E-P-T and L-E-P. In the third stanza, are deliberately not spelled correctly to create the rhyming effect. They are not spelled correctly, but still, to make it as a rhyming effect, they are being used in the poem. Okay, that tells about the word usage. We are coming to the now reading of the poem and understanding of the poem. Para number one. If ever you should go by chance to jungles in the east, suppose if you go by chance in the east, okay, what you can see? There are the jungles in the east. And if there should to you advance a large and tawny beast, and when you are advancing there while walking and you find a large tawny beast, tawny, a brownish color beast. Then, if he roars as you are dying, and once if it roars, you are dying, D-Y-I-N, dying means dying, going to die, you will know it is the Asian lion, and then only you come to know that, oh, in front of me, who is the great creature, that is the Asian lion, and my now life is in danger, only when you come to know, when you are in front of the Asian lion. Para number two. Or if sometimes when roaming round, a noble wild beast greets you, and suppose if you are roaming in the courtyard here and there in the open spaces in the forest and all, and there is the animal which welcomes you, which is that a noble wild beast, a noble, a very rich, okay, with black strips on a yellow ground, and there are black yellow strips on its ground, that is on the body. Just notice if he eats you, and just think of, he's going to eat you. Going to eat you. What will happen? The This simple rule may help you learn the Bengal tiger to discern. So this is the very simple rule. You can understand the Bengal tiger is going to kill you and eat you. Okay? This is all about the Bengal tiger. Discern, recognize. Coming to the para number 3. Strolling forth a beast you view. Strolling, strolling, strolling forth a beast you view. Strolling means walking leisurely and freely like a king. Okay? Whose hide with spots is peppered. Now whose skin is fully found with the dot dot pepper, that is spices. Okay? Spices we call pepper. As soon as he has leapt on you, the word has come now, leapt. Pelipiti, leapt, jumped. Leapt, jumped. You will know it is the leopard, and only when he jumps on you, you come to know, oh, this is the leopard. Leopard also other name by name cheetah or panther. It will do no good to roar with pain. It will do no good. He means it will do no good. E-W-I-L-L. Will means it will do no good to roar with pain, and we start having the pains. Okay, when it roars. It will only leap and leap again, and only it jumps on us, and that is enough. Okay, and we die. Coming to the para number next, that is para number 4. If when you are walking around your yard, you meet a creature there, and suppose if you are walking in the yard, that is in the open place here and there to the verandas or towards the forest side, etc. What you find? You meet a creature there, and there comes another creature, the guest, who hugs you very, very hard, and he gives you a very warm hug. And once if it hugs enough, or it possibly may give one more hug to care. Care means that we are still alive. And that caring is what? To kill us. And be sure it is a bear. And you will come to know, oh, it is a bear. And you have no chance to escape from the hug of the bear. If you have any doubts, I guess, he will give you just one more caress. And still you are found alive and moments are going on, he will give you one more caress. One more caress in sense, one more hug, and that is sufficient for you to finish or to end. Question, para number 5. Though to distinguish beasts of prey, a novice might nonplus. So there are distinguished beasts, and everyone is of a prey of each other. Everyone is food of one or the other animal. They are of varieties and kinds of animals, depend on each other's. A novice might nonplus. Now, who is a novice? Who is inexperienced? Who doesn't know about them? Okay. Who is a inexperienced person or a creature? Doesn't know about the other creatures or doesn't know about the other living beings over there. And what will happen? Nonplus. Nonplus, he gets confused. Oh, what can I do now? I am found in the forest. A number of creatures are being found there. And all wild are there. It will make you confused and panic. You will lose your strength, you will lose your hopes, and you will fall there only fatally. And tell from the hyena thus, the crocodile you always may, tell from the hyena thus. So always you might have seen the crocodile and all. It makes a weeping eyes and shows a sorrowful face. But it is not weeping or crying, but it is waiting for you to come near. As how you show the sympathy and kindness, it will pull you and eat you. This is how. Is it not? You might have heard about the poem, the crocodile and the monkey. Is it not? Same thing. It is always cheating us. Cunning. And hyenas come with merry smiles. And hyenas, they come in a group, it seems. Okay. It is also a kind of a wild dog, hyenas. Okay. And they always walk in a group. And they attack on a biggest of the biggest animal also. Very big animal also. Remember. But in a group. They have a unity. But if they weep, they are crocodiles. And suppose if they are weeping, they are the crocodiles. And if they are merry, happy, they are the hyenas. This is the activity or the outlook or the show off shown from the animals like crocodile and a hyena. So that they can come near to you and kill you. Or you should go near to the crocodile and it will kill you. Last para, the true chameleon is small. Now who is here now? A chameleon. Chameleon is a kind of a lizard. Okay? A lizard sort of thing. So it is a lizard, a kind of a lizard. He hasn't any ears at all. It doesn't listen or it doesn't hear because it doesn't have ears to listen. And not a single wing, even doesn't have any wing to fly. Okay, like other birds, they do have wings. If there is nothing on the tree, Then PIS again. This the chameleon you see, and it is the chameleon you see. If nothing is on the tree, you will find the chameleon. And chameleon always try to deceive us. In a blink of eye, we open and close. By the time the color is changed by the chameleon. Remember, such a very active and such a deceiving animal. It keeps on changing the color. Okay, and it is a lizard. It doesn't harms us, but it is also a kind of animal. It is mentioned in the poem. So this is all about your poem. How to tell wild animals by Caroline Wells. You are also going to know about the question and answers in general about this poem. Where is the Asian lion found? The Asian lion is found in the jungles of the east. And how does the Asian lion look? The Asian lion is a huge brownish beast. How will you feel if it advances towards you roaring? Suppose if it comes roaring, then if it advances towards us roaring, we will feel as if we are dying, we are going to die. You will encounter, what you will encounter in the jungles of the east? You will encounter an Asian lion in the jungles of the east. What kind of beast is the Bengal tiger? The Bengal tiger is a grand and impressive beast, very grand, very rich and very charming, impressive look. What is the color of his skin and strips? His skin is yellowish and he has a black strips on it. Black strips, the black lines. Okay. What will he do if he sees you? The moment he sees you, he will pounce on you to eat you. He will jump. Pounce means will jump on you to eat you. How will the simple rule help you? Now let's know what is the simple rule here. The simple rule will help you to understand that you are seeing the Bengal tiger. It is none other than the Bengal tiger which is in front of you. Where can you see the dark spots on the beast? The dark spots are scattered all over the hide. Hide means the skin of the animal. What will the animal do if he sees you? Answer is, he will jump at you the moment he sees you. So he will immediately jump on us. Will crying in pain be of any help? So crying is going to help you? No. No, crying in pain will be of no use, and as he will pounce upon you again, you are going to die. In the animal being described in the given lines of this paragraph, the leopard is being described in these lines. So who is this animal? The leopard. What will you do? What will you be doing in the courtyard? You will be walking around the courtyard. What will the animal do then? The animal will hug you hard. Okay. Then what will happen if you have any doubt? If you have any doubt, the bear will hug you again. So if you are found alive still, the bear once again, what will do? He will hug you. What is the bear known for? The bear is known for loving touch. Okay, hug is a loving touch. We welcome the friends and hug each other. Similarly, it hugs us to kill us. The last para. Who is like a lizard here in this poem? A chameleon is like a lizard in the poem. What does he lack in? What is not found in the chameleon? He doesn't have any ears and wings. So it doesn't have ears and wings. What can be said about the poet's views of chameleon? So what the poet says? A chameleon is similar to a lizard. It is same like a lizard. Is this creature very big? No. Chameleon is a very small creature. This is all about the poem, How to Tell Wild Animals. I hope so you have understood this poem with no any doubts and also cleared your satisfactory poem notes. Okay. Well, see you and log in the next class. Thank you. Bye.